What about helping Europeans wean themselves from dependency on Russian energy? Do you foresee the United States stepping up exports of U.S. oil or shale gas in the long run to Europe? And would that be an important part of a long-term strategy?
The energy piece is a huge part of the crisis with Russia. As you point out, EU member states, many of them are quite dependent on energy supplies for Russia. A country like Bulgaria is wholly dependent. A country like Germany, about 30% of its oil and gas comes from Russia. And Ukraine, of course, is dependent on Russia. And a lot of people are wondering what will happen this winter if things, rather than improving, actually become worse. And some people make the argument that really what we have here is an interdependence. Because yes, all of those European countries have an energy relationship with Russia, but Russia also depends, particularly on those EU member states, for hard currency. And so there's a question of what the damage to Russia would be of just cutting off those flows. And what you've seen the EU doing is working on what they call reverse flows, so that all the pipelines, of course, run from east to west, but creating a situation where you actually could send gas back to the east. So if Russia were to target Central and East European countries, that those in the west could actually have a reverse flow going back east.
And that's not something that the Russians could sabotage.
Oh, I'm sure there are all kinds of things the Russians could do, but it gets to whether the Russians are willing to jeopardize their energy relations with a country like Germany. And we just don't know the answer to that. If the Russians chose to cut off all energy supplies to Europe this winter, it would be very hard for Europe to replace those in the short term. You asked about LNG exports from the U.S. to Europe. Some people have suggested that as an answer to that challenge. But that's not a short-term answer. What folks here say is we're a couple of years away from actually being able to do that, A. And B, the U.S. has given export licenses to firms for those LNG supplies. But of course, this is a private sector business, and energy prices are higher in Asia. So those firms presumably will be sending those LNG exports to Asia rather than Europe. And so that's a question as well. They may be European firms that are getting those export licenses, but they're going to be driven by price in the marketplace. So it's unclear how that plays into this particular equation. There are also other opportunities in Europe. France apparently has large shale gas supplies. Poland has shale gas supplies. So I think there's going to be a mix of answers to this question. But the answer in the short term, there's no easy solution.
But hopefully the West, whether the United States and Europe, will be working on these alternatives for the longer term.
The U.S. and Europe absolutely are working on these alternatives, and there's an ongoing U.S.-EU energy dialogue. The EU has long been working on a common energy policy, and the crisis in Ukraine has given that an incredible push. And I would say the progress over the past several months has been substantial, and everybody recognizes this problem. And if there was flagging political will before to address it, that is not the case today.